sister. And after a while, I was like, oh, I'll just write a letter to Kelsey, and then I'll just kind of read it. So this is just my letter to you. So I have loved every minute of being your sister the past 26 years. We've shared so many adventurous, funny, sweet, and heartfelt memories together. How could I ever forget every combined birthday party we've had, every great or awkward dance we've been in, or every time we traveled to a different country for the sake of experiencing a new culture? Being named the Riker Strikers, after dominating all of the other church kids in Awanas in the three-legged race, was no small twist of fate. We were able to sprint side by side while everybody else was getting tangled, partly because we've always been on the same page and we just get each other. I love how we can just look at each other without speaking and know what the other one is thinking. You tell everyone that we're twins, and even though our birthdays aren't the same, sometimes I think we believe we actually are twins. And hey, I can't think of anyone I'd rather be a twin with than you. So, being a part of the Riker Striker duo has brought so much joy and happiness to my life. It's been such a privilege to watch you grow from a little girl who liked to streak around a dance contest in only tights, to now being a grown woman who's just as silly, but is also firm in her identity, compassionate, and kind. I love that you have found a man that shares all of your dreams, hobbies, and heart. Watching you two steal the show on Main Street and Disney World with your partner swing dancing was just one of the many times I realized you were made for each other. You both share an excitement for life, a love for people, and a passion to share the kindness of Jesus to the world around you. I look forward to watching both of you grow closer together as a couple, and I can already picture you two with gray hair, looking back on the incredible lives you've led, reminiscing about all the times the Lord's miraculous hand has guided the way. So you two are a power couple, the way you lead and in the way you love. I couldn't be more excited for you both as you start the next new chapter of your life. Congratulations, Kelsey and Taylor.
Hey guys. Hey, my name is Evan. I am one of the co-best men. I've had the honor of being selected. And Taylor and Kelsey are two of the dearest people in my entire life, truly. Taylor was my own best man in my wedding this past April, and when he asked me to be one of his best men, it was a stark moment in my mind, because I felt the exact same feeling that I felt the first day that I met Taylor. I was invited to kind of a group. A lot of us from back home used to participate in. We'd do every Saturday, we'd get together, and they would worship and just spend family time together, all these kind of random people who would come together as family. And I was invited, and I had never experienced anything like it. And I'd never met Taylor before in my life, but he called me up. I was 15 years old at the time, and he called me up, and after the whole group, he basically pulled me aside and was like, dude, I had said something during the group, and he was like, dude, that was amazing what you said. And I was like, what is he talking about? I barely even said anything. But what he was doing was calling out of me something I didn't even see in myself. I loved what Drew said during the ceremony about Taylor having the eyes of the Lord. Taylor seeing the things that aren't out in the open, but seeing deeper and pulling them out. And when Taylor asked me to be one of his best men, that honor that has run throughout our entire relationship was on full display, where Taylor surprised me with the way that he laid his life down to serve me, to call me up, and to show attention. Thank you. Co-best man, Bernie Brooks. And to show attention to someone who didn't feel like they deserved it. And I can honestly say in every respect, Taylor, that I would not be where I am, who I am, what I am today, if it weren't for you. And the doer and the actor and the servant that Taylor has always been finds its its completion and the dreamer and the believer and the hoper that Kelsey is. And I see the best of both of you on full display in complete unity. The work of Taylor's hands, his inspiration to get it done, to make it happen, to see it come through, whether it be in people or in projects. And Kelsey's unbounded, like crazy, whatever it is, she's going to believe it if it's what's in her heart. She's going to dream it. She's going to do it. She's going to see it happen. The fruition of that is going to be amazing. Out of this covenant, you guys will dream, believe, and do like the world has never seen before. You are so handcrafted for each other in such an amazing way. And so here's to you, to Taylor and Kelsey, to a fruitful covenant. As long as you both shall live, and thank you for inviting me into this story.
Hello. My name is Brandon. And I am the original vintage Brooks brother. I'm Taylor's older brother. And I am Taylor's first partner. Because it was always, this is before Kev's or Rebecca were in our life, it was Brandon, Taylor, and Corey and Sam. And I was trying to think about, like, what is it, like, what is between me and Taylor? What is special about me and Taylor's relationship? And I realized, like, man, we just do things. Like, me and, if you want something done, like, me and Taylor can do it, you know? And, like, we got so good at doing it because of Tom Walker over here. Shout out to Tom. We used to work for Tom on his property. And, man, we would spend all day just getting stuff done. Like, you need a trench dug. Me and Taylor can dig a good trench, you know? we used to drive there, and when I was old enough to drive, I'd drive us there, but then when I got there, Taylor would just drive us around, like, at 14, around the property in that truck that we killed eventually. It was some beautiful days, but I actually got to put my drink down because I wrote down what I wanted to say on my phone in a text message. So, come on. All right. So earlier when we were getting ready to go, we had communion together. Taylor led us, and it was beautiful. He said something that I thought was really profound about the blood of Jesus. He said that the kindness that we have for each other is because of that blood, and from that blood, from the Jesus that we get to have inside of ourselves. And it really made me think. When he said that, I thought that the reason that we are broken people in need of the blood of Jesus is because we are made so very powerful by our Creator. The divine gamble in the universe of the human beings is that God made us more powerful than we are wise. And it's most evident in a relationship, and even more so when you're married. Taylor and Kelsey, I promise that you are more powerful than you are wise, and that your words and your actions have far deeper consequences than you realize. And even though this should totally freak you out, it is also the most amazing thing that two people can do with each other. You are the biggest source of life and strength and joy for each other, and you are that completely by accident. As well-intentioned as you are, you don't even know the tiny things that you do that will bring each other joy and life and peace. And with that in mind, I wanted to say that Taylor and Kelsey, the greatest source of your strength in your marriage, is your earning potential or your emotional stability or your ability to protect each other or anything. Because when I think of Taylor and Kelsey, like, these are the two strongest, like, most able, like, oh my gosh, like, if anybody will succeed, it's these people, you know? Like, everything about you is like, yes, absolutely. And that's been the story for Taylor. I don't know Kelsey that well, but you can see it on your face. But that's been Taylor's story for a long time. Like, this man can get it done. This man will do a good job. But I wanted to say that the greatest source of strength in your marriage isn't all those things. It's your ability to put down the words you're holding as weapons and show your beautiful brokenness to each other in the hardest moment. It's those first 3 inches of moving closer to somebody when you don't trust them or yourself or anything anymore. That is where you're strongest, and that is where you can lead a marriage into fruitfulness. And that is the only appropriate stance at the feet of Jesus, and it's also the best way to love each other well. So, here is to Taylor and Kelsey.
I'd like to invite the Rags forward. Yeah, I think the dad's coming forward. He was just there. Oh, there he is. Take the mic, brother.
Test it, 1, 2. How can I top all that? You know, the thing you've seen tonight, this wedding has been so special. I'm going to talk a little bit about my daughter first. What a go-getter. Years ago, when she was trying out for track, in ninth grade, I came home one night from work and I said, "Hey, Kels." She goes, "Dad, I'm trying out for track." I said, "Well, first you got to beat me." She goes, "Dad, I can beat you." I said, "Well, let's see." So I stepped up 40 yards in front of our house. I was in pretty good shape still. I was about 285, not 325. Thought I ran about a 4.7. Used to.
Yeah.
Anyway, so me and Kels lined up, and I said, "Kels, we're going to go on my go. You okay? Don't cry if I beat you." So I lined up out there, and she didn't know I just came from happy hour. Anyway, she got me by a yard. She beat me by a yard, bottom line, in front of our house. It was pretty special. And I was really, you know, pretty good shape, pretty fast. And so she went on to, you know, run track and everything. It was quite a star. But the thing about Kelsey, she doesn't give up on anything or anybody. Good as gold. If she says it's going to be done, it's handled. Projects, all of her work. She left to go to DCC. Dallas County Chitters out of high school, and man, I was like blown away. All my friends were blown away. She not only made it right there, but 4 years. How about the DCC out there?
Yeah.
But before all that, what got her there too? The four pack. Where are you, four pack? Toughest nails, these girls. Got them all going, but just a great girl. She got into the Lord, and because of Pam, my beautiful wife, who Kelsey gets her looks from, by the way, you wouldn't want to be dating or married to a 6'4", 325-pound. Yeah, I see you looking at me. What I'm saying is just the love of the Lord. Started all this. And I'm so pleased to say, I'm so proud that you found a great man. And I'm excited for today. We're ready to have a great time today. And I want to talk about Taylor a little bit here. I've known him about a year. Great guy, polite, professional. Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. No, sir. No, ma'am. That kind of people. And that goes a long way in the South. So awesome. Take care of my daughter, you know. And I know you will. I know the Lord will always be with y'all. And I want to toast to y'all. Let's have a good time tonight.
At this point in time, Kelsey would like to invite her father to the floor to share a dance. Let's give a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen.
It's with great honor. I just say what has already been said. It's amazingly special to celebrate this night for these two that we love, but also just having everyone here as a family. It just means the world to us. We want to say thank you. And I'll keep this short, but I guess the thing I'd like to say, or we'd like to say to Taylor and Kelsey is something that Bieber hit on last night, I think it was, that two families come together and it's like they get grafted in like a tree, and how they're starting their own branch now. And when you have lots of kids, it's pretty exciting to see what happens. So, with Tom Walker's word, be fruitful and multiply. We look forward to seeing what happens there. Love you. To the new branch.
Don't go too far, because Taylor would like to invite you to the floor to share a dance.
Choice.